Howdy do everybody, this is Drew from Drew Thomas, and today I'm going to be telling you about the top 10 scariest logos from my childhood. This was inspired by a whole list of YouTubers, which I'm going to be showing right here, and, they all did a lot of great scary logo from childhood videos, so I thought, hey, how about I make one myself? And so that's what I'm doing. These logos may not be scary to you, but they're going to be scary to me from my childhood. Some of them still give me chills today, but they don't, like, full-on scare me anymore. But anyway, let's begin. So coming in at number 10, we first have American Public Television. This logo just, gave me a jump the first time because I wasn't expecting like the fast pace of the logo and the buildingness of the fanfare. And if all the WGBH logo, which, kind of made me uneasy, but it didn't scare me. But, it didn't really scare me, but, gave me a jump. Anyway, I will now show you why this logo scares me by showing you a video. So yeah, it's definitely a fast-paced logo, but it's not too scary. Now this next one, which is going to be number 9, is another one. Number 9, we have the Paramount DVD logo with menu. Paramount DVD. Well, I'm just going to describe why it scares me. All right, let's start. All right, oh look, it's the Paramount logo. Oh look, stars. I wonder what the stars are doing here. Oh, it's just, yeah, I was like, wait, what's that sound? Whoa, wait, where the frick did that fist come from? And then it just hits the mountain, and then, what the heck? And all of a sudden, it's just stuck there, waiting for your next move. Like, what are you gonna choose? Make a decision, and then all of a sudden, this happens. Wait, who turned out the lights? Where's the lights? Okay, anyway, I'm just gonna collect myself and tell you this. This appeared on a Dora DVD, and my father went up, press play. I'm like, press play already! I want to either see the previews or the main menu! Just get me off of this freaky thing! Anyway, so yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say about Paramount DVD. And now, on to number 8. So coming at number 8, we have the Universal Cartoon Studios logo. Oh my gosh, this logo gave me the creeps as a child because of the plain, the absent appearance of the universal text, and this appeared at the end of every Alvin and Chipmunk and Land Before Time film. It just, I'm just gonna show you what this logo is like, and I'm gonna show you why, this character got removed from JJ the Jet Plane, so enjoy the show! Honestly, what the heck was up with that logo? That was freaky. It was an airplane and he chuckled and, just the loudness of the fanfare and, oh my gosh. But don't even get me started on the plane. That plane is pure evil.
We know all your secrets, you stupid little plane.
Okay, I got a little bit carried away. Anyway, so moving on to number 7, we have the Walt Disney Home Entertainment logo. As mentioned in Roxy Entertainment's video, this logo scares us because of the sudden appearance of the fanfare. Me, well, it's kind of the same case. I shall now show you the logo, but you may want to turn down your speakers for this moment because this is going to get loud. However, the version that really gives me the creeps is definitely the alternate tune one because it's unexpected. Here it is. Oh, come on. I prefer the original tune. I mean, for cripe's sake. Can we just have the original tune? Anyway, so, to make matters worse, the logo also has a variant on live-action movies where it takes place on a black background, just like this. And to make matters even more worse, there's even one with the alternate tune on Santa Claus 3, The Escape Clause. So yeah, this logo definitely gave me a spook. Yikes! So coming in at number 6, we have the THX Tex2 Mucan logo, the Monsters, Inc. variant. Well, I'm going to just, you know, show you this logo to see why it's scary, and then I'll describe to you why I find it scary after I show you the logo. Here it is! Okay, so the first thing I notice when, you know, the THX logo starts is that it starts on a black background. And then Tex just flies down and, you know, he actually looks cute and, you know, he's just a moo can. And, you know, it turns upside down, it goes moo, he shrugs, pulls out a cord out the hatch, and then, you know, plugs it into the moo can. Wait, how's that possible? And then, you know, it's a bunch of moves, and then move the deep note. Then the logo shakes and shudders. Tex is frightened and runs away. He pulls the THX logo. Then down drops, you know, the best sound, the best picture watching a THX certified feature with one last cow moo. It's very ominous. Ugh. And not to mention that the cows replace the deep note. That sounds freaky. Yikes! And now take my hand, for we're now entering my childhood nightmares. Anyway, so coming in at number 5, we have the Big Idea logo from 2002 to 2015. I'm going to explain why this logo scares me right after I show you it. But the main reason why it scares me is because of, you know, Bob's face when he's trying to get through the D. Here it is. So the main reasons why this logo scared me was because the clicking and Bob, you know, showing his teeth when he was trying to get out the letter D. That was definitely creepy. And I'll explain more about the clicking noise when I get to number 1. Until then, let's get to the next number, which will be... Number 4! The Sony Computer Entertainment logo, PS2 Startup. Oh my gosh, this logo. I hate this logo with a burning passion. Even the noise today, it just... feels so ominous. It goes shh, bah! Out of nowhere. It's just scary. I had a friend who had a PS2, and every time he would turn on the PlayStation or start a DVD or a game, this startup would come on. It is especially scary when you watch it in the dark. And what also doesn't help is, you know, there's also an RSOD variant, which, you know, don't watch if you're scared of this. Anyway, here it goes, you've been warned. Right as soon as the music ends, it's just the fiery sounds and, you know, it reminds you of the angry fires of hell. This is definitely scarier than its predecessor. I definitely do not recommend putting in a bad disc into the PlayStation 2. Anyway, so on with the next logo, which is even creepier. So coming in at number 3, we have the Walt Disney blue format screen seen on all Disney VHS's, and yeah, so this definitely gives me the creeps because of the largeness of the font and, you know, for how fast it fades in and out, and I'm going to show it to you, especially creepy how there's dead silence. Watch. See? Nothing. It's just silent. It just creeps me out. It just comes on, and then it just fades away quickly as possible. So yeah, and the largeness of the font, it looks huge. Just take a good look at it. Yikes, it's huge. Oh my gosh. And I also know what you're thinking. Drew, why are you afraid of this logo? I'm, you know, it's not like I can follow something that scares you. Well, number 2. The Disney Feature Presentation logo from 1999 to 2006. Well, it helps with all Disney companies, but you know, it mainly helps with Buena Vista. This logo definitely gave me creeps. Why? Because it's way different than the other film reel bumpers. One, it starts on a gold background instead of the actual film reel background. Two, the music is different. Three, it's seen before a movie, not before a trailer. Well, you know, that part I can let slide. Anyway, and now, here's the logo.
And now, our feature presentation.
And another part that scares me of this logo is how all of a sudden the announcer is. Because, you know, there is the logo, and then also he just goes, "And now, our feature presentation!" Oh my gosh, just thinking about it just gives me the creeps. And the music, you know, in addition to the synth, now they added strings. However, you know. And, you know, it also, well, comes before, like, the THX logo, which makes it feel uneasy. And it comes before the blue modified screen. Anyway, so, yeah, this logo definitely scared me. And eventually, I overcame that fear, and now I actually love this logo, and now it's seen before the Every Drew Thomas video. So yeah, I definitely enjoy this logo. Anyway, so before we get to number one, here are a few quick honorable, in this case, dishonorable mentions. Sony Wonder. Ah, Sony Wonder. This shows before Elmo tapes, and while I'm neutral to this one, except I don't like how it just goes nice and soft, and then it goes BAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAA man. Yikes, there's children. The Lucasfilm Ltd. THX logo. As a kid, I mainly did not like it because it was ominous. And on the VHS, how, you know, the volume was like raised to like... And this was actually mentioned on Roxy Entertainment's video. She was frightened by this too, because of the loud noise. However, now I love this logo today. Anyway, the Walt Disney Classics logo. I mainly don't like it because it starts out ominous when it shows Sorcerer Mickey, but then the fanfare is nice until it gets to the... Then it just, you know... It just scares you, and almost like it's going to consume you. It's just frightening. The Paramount Feature Presentation logo. Now this one, it was definitely one I did not like because loud fanfare, deep low voice, and the zooming of the text and the dead silence that follows afterwards. I definitely did not like it, but hey, I grew neutral to this logo eventually. And now, congratulations, you made it to number one. Here it comes. Prepare to get scared. It might not be scary to you, but it was my childhood nightmare. Here it is! Lionsgate. Oh my gosh, this logo. This logo was my number one childhood nightmare. As a kid with autism, I do not like hot industrial machines. Even the sight of it. Which is why, every time I would see a hot industrial machine, I would feel uneasy. Especially when they have suspenseful music playing over it. A prime example would this being SpongeBob's Chumps Ahoy. Whenever, you know, they were working on Sandy's new invention. And yeah, this definitely gave me the creeps, and I'll tell you why when I show you this logo. So yeah, everything about this logo is creepy in my opinion, especially due to the fact that, you know, we just saw Gears and then when the doors open, it's just the Lionsgate text in the sky out of nowhere, and the music is just, you know, suspenseful, almost like it's an action film. It's just, ugh. Everything about this logo makes me just run out of the room, hide, and, you know, one time I was like so afraid of it, I would not have mom buy anything that was Lionsgate, and she did not. Eventually, I overcame this fear, and now I like this movie. No, this logo. Why do you say movie? Anyway, so, yeah. And to make matters worse, there's a horror logo, which I'll show to you. Warning, this is the real scary part, so why, if you're watching this, you better click off right now, because it's gonna get scary. Besides, the video's almost done anyway. Alright, here goes. No. Please. I beg you. Let the madness in. Please. So, That was why I was afraid of it. That was why I have always feared it. That's why I would run away, hide, be safe, be secure, at a sanctuary more safe than the scary gates of Lionsgate. And in conclusion, these logos may have scared me as a child, but not anymore. Well, I guess it wraps up this video, so I do have a question for you. What is the scariest logo in your opinion? Let me know down in the comments below, and thank you for watching this video. Be sure to click that subscribe button and ring the bell to be notified when we upload a new video. This is Drew from Drew Thomas saying, you're in the dark, seeing nothing. Buy some Thomas merchandise, and happy Halloween.